Welcome to one of our cell science labs. Today, we're gonna thaw some cells. We're gonna go into the liquid nitrogen tank.
This stores liquid nitrogen. Basically, it has racks in it that will store our cells. So these can get kind of heavy, and I'm kind of short, so I have to like. So I'm gonna go into box F. So here we have all of our cells. I'm gonna put that in a little cooler of dry ice so that they stay cold. Now we can head over into our other lab. And I have a couple of team members in there that are doing cell stuff right now. And this is our tissue culture room. I'm gonna hand this vial off to Haley and she will thaw it from its frozen state and we'll plate it onto a brand new plastic dish. Let us go in. I have brought you lamin cells. It looks perfect because it's about the size of a pea, because by the time you dry the vial off and ethanol it and put it in the hood, it's essentially gonna be thawed all the way.
Yes.
Deft fingers, Haley, deft fingers. We're gonna transfer the cells into a 15 milliliter conical that we will then spin down to isolate our cell pellet. That's spinning down at 1,000 rotations per minute, and so that is gonna push all of your cells down into the bottom of the tube. Cells need certain, you know, sugars, growth factors, and stuff like that. And so we actually have to feed our cells every day. Haley's basically just resuspending in that food we were just talking about, and then she'll plate it on the plate. But today, I'm gonna be imaging in suite 526. Basically, what you saw in our tissue culture room light is where we maintain our cell lines, right? So we passage them over and over, and while we maintain them on plastic, we can also plate them on glass for live imaging. We have like an incubation chamber, so it's CO2 and temperature calibrated, so we can actually watch the cells grow. Now it's all tucked in. What you're looking at right now is one of our gene-edited stem cell lines. Sort of easier to see near the top, but in the white is the endogenously tagged protein, CDH1. The pink is a cell membrane dye. The blue dye is a DNA dye. We have all of our cell lines that we have QC'd and released, right, that can go into other labs. So people that study, you know, the mitochondria, people that study the Golgi are able to use these lines in their own labs. We basically want to create these cell lines and create tools from the data that we collect to empower the scientific community. And I feel like for me, that's the most important thing.